19 July, the date when Raj Kundra was arrested, and on 21st September, more than 2 months later, Raj Kundra finally walked out of jail, looking frail and sporting a lal tikka on his forehead. In between these two dates, his bail plea was rejected multiple times. So what exactly made the magistrate sign off his release on bail order this time around? The main reason this time is inducement, which the judge said was missing in this case. Now, inducement literally means offering something to somebody to make that person do something. The court said that the element of inducement, which is vital to prove cheating, is missing from the Mumbai Crime Branch's case against businessman Raj Kundra. मतलब राज कुंद्रा के केस में ये साबित नहीं हो पाया है कि उन्होंने किसी को भी कोई जासा देकर या कुछ और इंसेंटिव देकर कुछ करवाया हो, और चीटिंग यानी कि धोखाधड़ी का मामला साबित करने के लिए ये एक बहुत ही इंपॉर्टेंट फैक्टर है. नाउ ऑन दिस ग्राउंड मैजिस्ट्रेट SP भाजीपाले ग्रांटेड बेल नॉट ओनली टू राज कुंद्रा बट ऑल्सो टू इज एसोसिएट रायनथॉप, स्टेटिंग दैट द अक्यूज कुडंट बी केप्ट बिहाइंड द बार्स टिल द एंड ऑफ द ट्रायल मियरली for further investigation. The court referenced a previous Supreme Court order to support its decision. Now, according to police, Kendron Private Limited, a UK-based company, owned the Hotshots app, and investigations reveal that Raj Kundra, through his company Vian Industries, was managing this app. Raj Kundra's another company called Arms Prime Media Limited is alleged to have developed and sold Hotshots to Kendron Private Limited, which actually just belongs to his London-based brother-in-law, Pradeep Bakshi, who is shown as absconding in the 1400 plus page charge sheet that also has the statements of 40 people, including that of Shilpa Shetty, who reportedly told the police last week that she was too busy in her own work to notice what exactly her husband Raj was doing. Now, among these statements was also the statement of one Megha Jaiswal, an accountant at Vian Industries, which was recorded to connect the accused with the transactions of the company. To this, the court said that from her statement, it can only be gathered that the transactions took place between Kendron and Hotshot and there was exchange of money. But that is not an offence that has been levelled against the accused in the present charge sheet of the Mumbai police. Now, as you know, generally the courts look at the technicalities of the case and go by the charge sheet that is filed by the police. So in this case, the court further observed that the server, laptops and mobile phones of Vian Industries are already in the investigating officer's custody. So there cannot be any tampering of evidence and hence the bail is justified in this case. The court said that it will not be proper to keep the accused in the custody when they are ready to furnish surety for their appearance. Now, Raj Kundra's lawyers had argued in the court that Kundra and Thorpe were not related to uploading or broadcasting of the questionable content on the app, but the charge sheet by the Mumbai police clearly states that Raj Kundra had set up the Hotshots app for distributing pornographic material. You let me know what are your thoughts on this latest development in the Raj Kundra case. As the trial very much continues in this case, what do you think will happen next? You can connect with me on Instagram and on Facebook. It's @ReviewRon on both. Like, share and subscribe here, of course, if you find my videos worth it. But even if you don't do any of these things, thank you so much for watching this one. Please take care of yourself and those around you. Jai Hind.